Good evening. Today, I bought this Charbroil Flavor Chamber, and I'm pretty excited about trying it out. So, I got a 1.84 pound chuck roast, and anyhow, it says to use beer, wine, marinade, or fruit juice to add flavor and moisture. And, well, I said that beer, so I've got some of that Leinenkugel's summer shandy that we'd bought last summer for a get-together, and I've still got about half a 12-pack left just sitting there. And I thought, well, I might as well use that. And I got to thinking about the fruit juice, and, well, summer shandy is beer with lemonade in it. So anyway, I was thinking, well, that lemonade, that sounds like that'd be a good marinade for this. So anyhow, tonight I'm gonna put that roast in a marinade of I'm gonna use some Worcestershire sauce and some garlic powder and a little sea salt, and then I'm gonna put that roast in a plastic bag and let it soak overnight in the refrigerator, and then in the morning we're gonna try this baby out and see how it comes out. So I'll see you in the morning. So I've had my meat marinating all night in a mixture of lemonade. It's 12 ounces of lemonade, 3 tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce, 2 tablespoons of sea salt, and 1 tablespoon of garlic powder. And for the steaming, I've got this Leinenkugel's summer shandy that's been sitting over there collecting dust since last summer. And there's a little bit of styrofoam there that I didn't get out. So, but I've washed the grate in this. So I'm going to put some summer shandy in it. And it looks like it'll just take a whole bottle of that. You're supposed to use a cup, but I wanted to use more liquid. And I'll dump in some Worcestershire sauce. And that's probably 2 tablespoons. I did measure it out last night for my marinade. And then I'm just got some regular lemonade here that I'm gonna add to it. I thought it needed more liquid because it's gonna be a fairly long cooking time. And you see I've actually touched the bottom there. So and now, so I'll just kind of center that. And I'll pull my meat out. Yeah. I think that's gonna be good. I put it with this side up, with the theory being that the fat would go through the meat. Not sure that my theory is correct, but that's it. Now I'll put it on the grill. Well, that's a nice morning. It's about 24 degrees. It's a slight northwest breeze. So it's a good morning to grill. The first thing I'm gonna do is clean my grate off. Pour the charcoal in. Cooking time. Fortunately, I got more charcoal. I always like to keep several bags of charcoal on hand at all times. Fluid. See if I can get this licked. Then that really wasn't much of a problem, was it? Thank you. going pretty good. Okay. The charcoal was going real good. Then I decided, since I've got such a long cooking time going on here, that I would add more unlit charcoal on the top of it. So I did that. And now I'm gonna add the rack. And it looks like I'm thinking it's time to put the meat on. Ooh-ha! Place the flavor chamber with the meat and the liquid in it right directly over the hot coals, and I'll see if my lid will clear. Oh yeah, and we'll just let this cook. And we'll see how it all comes about. Mmm, look at that. Okay. This is designed so you can pull the lid with a spatula. Pretty slick idea. And it's only cooked for a little over an hour, so I think I've probably well overestimated the cooking time. But we will temp it out. 150. Well, this is well done. It's up to 165. So, if you like your meat well done, this is it. For me, I think I've overcooked it a little bit, to my taste, but that's the way it goes some days, and I've never done this before, so you learn every time you do something new. So I will put this lid back on and remove it from the heat. Well, that didn't work as planned, but this will. There we go. Okay, I've let it sit for about 15 minutes right in that roaster deal, and as you see, it's 172 degrees internal temperature, which would make it well done. Okay, I'm gonna cut this baby open and see what we got here. Yeah, it's definitely well done. So I'll know next time to remove it a little sooner. I'm gonna taste it.
That's a good flavor.
And after using my flavor chamber once here, I've concluded that I'm going to be happy with it. And I'll use it again. I'll have to try the smoking part the next time. But the next time I attempt to roast, I'm going to need to keep a little closer eye on it. And everybody makes mistakes now and then. You don't learn anything if you don't. So I think a little less cooking time would be in order the next time. So, and even though, boy, the roast beef had a wonderful flavor, marinating it in that lemonade mixture, which some people might sound a little crazy, but I'm just not afraid to try these things. All right. Thank you, and come back and watch some more of my videos of things that I do from time to time. And have a good day. Goodbye.